The first thing is makeup products. How to choose the right makeup products when it comes to creating a basic makeup look. I have categorized the products into the products that we need and the products that we want. What products we need are without which we cannot complete a makeup look. Need जो हम लोगों को ज़रूरत है without which हम एक makeup look create नहीं कर पाएंगे वो products है moisturizer, concealer, compact lipstick as well as a mascara. These five products if we have we can create a complete makeup look. And the other products are like blush, contour, foundation, bronzer, eyeshadows, then eyeliner, eyebrow pencil, eyebrow pomade, eyebrow powder. There are several products in the market when it comes to makeup. But what we need is what I am going to talk about in this video and create a makeup look using only those five products. So I do not have any makeup on right now. The only thing I have on is a lip balm that I have used because I have chapped lips. I have cracked lips. My lips are dry, which is why I have used lip balm. And this lip balm will help make sure that when I apply lipstick, my lips do not crack or my lipstick does not crack. So the first step of any makeup look is a good skin prep. And for the skin prep, we do not require hundreds of products. The only basic product required for skin prep is a good moisturizer. Now, when you all go in the market to buy moisturizers, hundreds of options are available. But how do you choose the right moisturizer for your skin? Firstly, you have to understand your skin type. When we in early in the morning when we touch our T-zone, this is our T-zone. So when we touch our T-zone, if it is oily, if it is greasy, then you have oily skin type. Or if it is dry, you have dry skin type. If it is oily in the T-zone and dry in the other areas, then you have combination skin type. So once you know what your skin type is, you have to then understand that there are several options of moisturizers available to you. The basic ones are a gel based moisturizer and a cream based moisturizer. So if you have oily skin, you have to go in for a water based or a gel based moisturizer. And if you have dry skin, then you have to go for the cream based moisturizer that will hydrate your skin and leave it plump to apply for the next step of the makeup. So I have oily skin, so I use a gel based moisturizer. If you see over here, it is written clearly gel cream. So this gel based moisturizer does not make my skin oily when I am having any makeup on or no makeup on as well. It is over actually. Squeeze the last bit out of it. Okay, so what I was saying is that gel based moisturizer will not leave your skin oily, but hydrate your skin, hydrate it to a level that it is required. This is all the amount of moisturizer that you need. 2 finger, 3 finger, 4 finger. I don't understand the logic of why people say that you require that much of moisturizer. This is all the moisturizer that I take. I blend it using my fingers and then apply it all over my face. I do have a bird at my house which makes a lot of noise when I talk. I'm not even looking at him. If I look at him, he'll scream even more. So if you all are getting disturbed by his noise, I'm really sorry. Okay, so after your skin is hydrated, is all set for the makeup, the next step is concealer. Now, what is the main motive of a concealer? The concealer is basically used to reduce pigmentation. I have written down everything in this book, so I am going down again and again. to see what have I written. Okay, so concealer is used to reduce pigmentation. Basically, everybody says that concealer hides pigmentation. I do not understand the logic of how concealer hides the pigmentation. I feel it reduces it. The more concealer you use, the lighter your pigmentation becomes. And if you want to cover it completely, what we have to use is correctors. Different correctors for different problems. For example, now my dark circle, it is not that evident. So I do not use any corrector. I just use a concealer and it reduces the pigmentation that is there around my eyes. But I have a lot of pigmentation around my mouth. So when I have to do a heavy makeup look, what I do is I use this orange color corrector that is there. This corrector palette is only for 200 rupees. So I take the orange color corrector and I apply it around my mouth so that it hides the pigmentation around the mouth. And then I use a concealer from this palette itself or else my favorite concealer from K Beauty. So for now, I will be using the K Beauty's concealer. How to understand which shade of concealer you should be picking up? If you go to a store, the people there will guide you about what concealer shade you should be, what concealer shade suits perfectly for you. But if you are ordering it online, then how to understand which concealer is going to suit you the best is you have to see the color of your veins. These veins, now if you see on this hand of mine, the color of these veins is purple and green, which means that I have neutral undertone. The category of the classification of the three tones are warm undertone, neutral undertone and cool undertone. If you have pinkish and purplish nerves, that means it is cool undertone. The way I have mixed color. Okay, so if you have green or olive color veins, then it is warm undertone. And if you have both the colors, then you have neutral undertone. So since I have purplish as well as olive color, green color veins, which means that I am a neutral undertone. So I have selected the shade 150 N medium. Medium is the color of your skin. N means neutral. Y is going to mean yellow and C is going to mean cool. So I have selected 150 N medium, which suits my skin type the best, which is a perfect color for my skin tone. Always wipe off the excess from the wand. You do not require a lot. So I apply two dots here, and one here, since I have a lot of pigmentation in this area. Two dots here, one dot here, and then one dot here. I use my fingers to blend the concealer. What I do is I dab it under my eyes. Dab, 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 dab. Dab until it is gone. It is completely invisible. Do you see how just by dabbing it with the finger, it is gone completely, and the pigmentation that was there under my eyes has also been reduced. Okay, so the third product is a compact. The compact is used to set everything in place. Now, I have not applied too much foundation, so I do not have anything over here. but I do require some coverage. So compact provides you with coverage. Different compacts are made for different purpose. So now the compact that I have is from Faces Canada, which has medium coverage, light to medium coverage, and it is buildable. But if I use Lakme 95 compact, then it gives me a full coverage. So I do not require foundation. I'll be applying the compact by Faces Canada. Using a foundation in these hot summer days is really going to make your makeup look more cakey. That is why I prefer using a compact over a foundation. But if you want to use a foundation, make sure you're setting your foundation with a compact very nicely. Okay, so the next product is a lipstick. Lipstick basically is used on lips, but it can be used on several other parts of your face and can do the work of several other products. For example, now from these lipsticks that I have, I'll pick this light pink shade, and this I will be using on my eyes. What I'll do is I'll take a little bit on my finger and apply it on my eyelid and just blend it out. So it has done the work of a eyeshadow. Same thing on the other eye. Now I can use the same thing as a blush as well. This lipstick I'll be taking a little bit on my finger and then apply it where I would apply my blush, that is on the apples of your cheek. Okay. After which, now how to understand what kind of lipstick is going to suit you the best? I have extremely dry lips, Sahara Desert lips, because of which I have to constantly apply a lip balm. The lip balm that I use in US has really helped me is this lip balm by Laneige, which is amazing. I don't think I need to speak about this lip balm. It is expensive, but it is worth every penny that you pay. So if you're thinking about investing in a good lip balm, go for this one. The tub version or this tube version, both are really nice. So if you have dry or chapped lips, you have to use a lip balm before you apply any lipstick. But if you are applying a lip balm, make sure, I prefer applying a matte lipstick over my lip balm so that it dries and there is still lip balm which hydrates my lips. Okay, so now today I'll be not using a lipstick on my lips, but I'll be using this Colorstay Satin Ink, which is basically a lip tint. Tint means a very thin formula that gives color to the lips and also feels very light, light onto the lips. So I have purposely chosen this product because it does not suit my skin tone. I have dusky skin tone and it does not suit my skin tone. But today I'll be showing y'all how to make it work when you have dusky, when a certain lipstick is not working for your skin tone. So I'll first apply this lipstick and show it to you. I forgot to take off my lip balm. I would usually take off my lip balm and then apply this, but it's okay. Okay, so if you see, it looks really bad on me. So what I would do is, I would take a darker lipstick or a darker lip. I would have applied a lip liner before, a darker lip liner. That would have also worked. But I prefer applying a darker lipstick on the border of my lips and then blending it together. Thank you. You see, the lipstick that was not looking nice on me suddenly started to look very nice, very beautiful. And the last product that I had to talk about is a mascara. The mascara that I use is by Lakme. It is their iconic version. Another mascaras that I have used and are really good is a mascara by Maybelline. It is their Lash Sensational Mascara. Lash Sensational Mascara. Other than that, Lash Paradise is also really nice that I have used. I think I have used only those mascaras. Okay. So, mascara helps lengthen the eyelashes, also gives it a fuller look. Why have I chosen a mascara over an eyeliner? Is because not everybody is skilled enough to draw a perfect line above the eyelid. But using a mascara is very simple. Just hold the mascara's wand and then brush your eyelashes using the wand. Rather, what I like to do is I like to wiggle the mascara wand so that it coats the lashes properly. And if you apply a mascara, I don't think you need to apply an eyeliner. Do you see how it makes a difference? How the mascara makes a huge difference? The eyelashes the eyes instantly looks a little more wider, a little more fresh. So this completes a basic makeup look. If you see, everything is put together. I have makeup on my face, which is not too much, but it's still pretty and can be used for an Indian as well as Western look. So do let me know, how did you like this video, and if any feedback to be given to me, please put it down in the comments. I will surely look down upon there. Bye. Also, do not forget to like this video, to share it with your friends, and to share it with all those people who require to know a little more about makeup, who want to know a little more about makeup. Comment down below, share this video, and subscribe to my channel. That's it. Bye bye.